Kanika Singh is a historian, and her research interests include museum and heritage politics in contemporary India, Delhi's history and its medieval monuments, and teaching pedagogy. Her research focuses on museums and heritage in contemporary India, with a particular interest in Sikh museums. Her PhD was on representation of heritage in Sikh museums with a case study of the museum at Sisganj Gurudwara in Delhi. She looks at how Sikh history, identity, and popular visual culture come together in the museum to create an authoritative notion of Sikh heritage. Her teaching and research include Delhi's history, its monuments, visual culture, and writing pedagogy. In this video, she talks about her work on Sikh museums and on museums in South Asia and her role as the founder of Delhi Heritage Walks. Kanika Singh is the director of the Center for Writing and Communication at Ashoka University.
I'm a historian and I'm interested in museums and heritage politics in contemporary India. And I'm especially interested in Sikh museums. So, and why? Sikh museums are quite unusual, actually. So there have been many Sikh museums which have been built in independent India. And you will see that unlike most museums you're familiar with, which have historical artifacts, old stuff, Sikh museums, the display overwhelmingly is made up of modern history paintings. You know, what we identify as calendar art. And these are paintings which depict scenes from the Sikh past. And many of these museums are associated with Gurdwaras. They've also been made by the government. So I'm especially interested in why are they being made? Who is making them? When are they being made? And why so many Sikh museums, you know, since independence? I'm also interested in seeing that what is the notion of Sikh heritage these museums represent? So I use my study of Sikh museums to understand these questions. And I think Sikh museums are an excellent vantage point for understanding the heritage politics in contemporary India, and also to understanding what exactly is the nature of the museum. How do we understand a museum as an institution as it has developed in India? I started Delhi Heritage Walks way back in 2009 with a friend, Rajesh Ranjan. Why I started this? I'm absolutely crazy about monuments. In fact, I love to say that the more ruinous, the better. And I love walking. I love walking. Delhi has increasingly become an unwalkable city, but till very recently, I would walk everywhere, you know, several kilometers for several hours exploring the city. And as a historian, I'm deeply interested in architecture and questions of heritage. I also very strongly believe that every one of us, even those who are not professional historians, must engage with the questions of heritage, of questions of history, and know their city, know the place where they live, know the people who inhabit the city. So Delhi Heritage Walks became, you know, sort of combined all of this, and it became an excellent platform to pursue these interests. As a student, I had done walks for other organizations which already existed before 2009, but they were usually so badly organized and without any actual research work into the site, the location, or even the visitors who are coming there. So if I were to share with you just one episode which really affected me, it was the fact that I was once sent to lead a walk for a group of very young school children. And it was only when I met them at the site where we were supposed to explore the monuments, I realized that they were hearing impaired. And nobody had bothered to find this out and inform me of this. So that was, you could say the last straw. And I thought that if I really want to do it well, I should do it on our own. So that was the beginning of Delhi Heritage Walks. This is way back when I had just started Delhi Heritage Walks in the initial years, and I was on a recce trip to the fort of Tughlakabad in Delhi. I'd studied it about it as part of my postgraduate degree, written a seminar paper on it and so on. And this was one of the initial trips where I was trying to design a walking route in it. And so I had some archaeological reports, some old photographs, and I took them as my research material walking into Tughlakabad Fort. I was alone. And many people warned me, even in and around Tughlakabad, that I shouldn't be doing this alone. It's not a safe place for a young woman to be. I disregarded the advice. It was the middle of the day, and I just walked in after having got my ticket. And it turned out to be one of the most memorable things I had done while working at Delhi Heritage Walks. And why? Because I met a member of the transgender community from Delhi who had made this Tughlakabad Fort as her base for her daily work. So we often know that we come across transgender in traffic crossings or near monuments where they are seen to be troublesome, extorting money from couples especially. Here, I was alone and she decided to walk with me and explore the fort with me. So what was perceived by everyone to be a potentially dangerous situation turned out to be an extremely enriching conversation. She took me around the fort. We walked, talked about not only the fort, but how she negotiates the place, why she is here, what are her experiences. And this is one of my most memorable homeworks I have done for Delhi Heritage Walks. And it's also important for me to that these experiences should be shared with others, because use of public space by women or members of the queer community, transgender community, does change your perception of the city. It's important for acknowledging these experiences, yeah, and not merely the monuments in stone or the ruins you're there. So I think it's one of the episodes during my experience with Delhi Heritage Walks that has really stuck with me. I want to use my experience at Delhi Heritage Walks to understand the growth of heritage industry in Delhi. So you must be aware that the past few years has seen a tremendous interest in the idea of promoting Delhi's heritage, its monuments, its culinary culture, the crafts communities in and around Delhi. And you can see this in the increasing number of groups and individuals offering heritage walks in the city. The city has also officially tried to get the UNESCO heritage status as well. So I'm interested in looking at questions of why is this sudden interest in Delhi's heritage and the need to promote it? What are the implications of this? What is being offered as Delhi's heritage? Who are the consumers of this heritage? And what is the political economy, the economic dimensions of these initiatives? So these are my research questions for Delhi. And I'm also interested in studying the social history of museums in South Asia. So at Ashoka, I teach courses on history and politics of museums in this region. And South Asia is especially interesting region to study because it has a common history, it has a shared culture, but it also has a history of competing interests among the various national and social groups. So museums have emerged in South Asia from the colonial times after establishment of independent nation states and are still being created. Yeah. So I want to see that how are museums used as a platform to understand these geopolitical concerns of national and identity politics in this region, and then the idea of heritage, who is making these museums and why. So I think this would be a good opportunity. Studying museums in South Asia would be a good opportunity to understand the politics, identity, religion, questions of memory and history. How are they interacting, especially in the region of South Asia?